Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, welcome. In today's video, I'm gonna be sharing my top tips on how to teach your babies to talk. So this was actually something someone asked me and I decided to just go ahead and do a whole video on it just in case anybody else is out there that needs help on how to teach their babies to talk. So let's just go ahead and get started. I have my little journal in front of me just for like the notes that I wrote for myself. So if you see me looking down, that's what I'm doing. But let's just go ahead and get started with number one. So my first tip is to talk to your child like they are a regular person. I did this with Noah starting from like when he was born. I did have moments, and I still do have moments, where I like have like a baby voice with him. But when I talk to him, the majority of the time I'm talking to him like he is an adult. Like I am just telling him, like I talk to him like this, literally. I'm like, okay, now we're gonna go do the dishes and now I have to go clean your room. Like I talk to him like an adult, literally from the moment he was born. Like he was a little baby and I'm talking to him in big words. Like, I don't know, I feel like sometimes we can kind of dumb things down and baby talk too much with our kids. So I know like that's a big thing in like the Portuguese language. So for an example, like for food or like to eat, we say like papa, and that doesn't really mean anything, but that's just like our little thing. So when Noah was little, we would use these words with him. Like we would say like, okay, it's time for papa, but I would also make it a point to be like, papa, eat food, like just so he knows these little baby words that we use with you do have meanings, and they mean like eat food, like nanai. We always say nanai, but I always also say like, it's bedtime, it's time to go nanai, all right, you're gonna go to sleep now. Like, so he kind of knows that all means the same and we never just stuck to like nanai or papa or whatever. Like we always tell him what's actually going on, even if we are using these like more baby-like words. But my tip would be to just stay away from those words and like dumbing things down for your kids and just straight up talking to them like they're adults. It can kind of seem weird, but honestly, the more you do it, the more comfortable you get with it, and then you realize like they're just little people and you're gonna talk to them regularly. Of course, yeah, I do have my moments where I'm like, oh, you're so cute. But like for the most part, we're talking to him like an adult. I do have like videos. If I can find one, I'll like insert it. But I have always just talked to him like about real life things. I'm like, do you want a brother or a sister? And he's like a month old. So yeah, I always talk to him like he is a regular adult person. My second tip is actually probably the most important one. It's just to train him to respond to things the way I want him to respond to things. So I know that sounds a little bit crazy, but just for some background information, I have worked with children with like autism, and I was an ABA therapist, and ABA just stands for Applied Behavioral Analysis. So I'm not gonna sit here and like teach you how to become an ABA therapist. I'm pretty sure that's like not legal, but I am gonna give you guys tips on how to do this and what this looks like. So a lot of this is just a lot of reinforcements. So like fun things, things that your kids want or like. And a lot of it is like repetition, like so much repetition until you essentially train your kid to do what they want you to do. There is like psychology behind this. It's literally like conditioning someone the same way that you would do a dog. Like to train a dog is literally to teach them. And that's literally the same thing you do with your kids, is to train them or teach them to respond to something a certain way or to do something a certain way. So the way I do this with Noah is, I'm trying to think of like examples I can give you guys, but basically I taught him how to say thank you. And the way I did that was by like ABA therapy, basically. So what I would do is if he asked me like for a snack, like he wants crackers, I would go ahead and give him his crackers and I would prompt him to say like, thank you, mommy. And he would repeat it. And then I would try it again. So I would then go, thank you, mommy. And then he would repeat it. And we would do that back and forth until he said it independently. So the moment I give it to him and he says, thank you, mommy, on his own, I give him it. Like, oh, now you have your snack. Like, this is a really fun thing. This is what you wanted. That's like his reinforcement. Like, he gets to have it because he said thank you. So now he's learned, okay, when she hands me this, I say thank you and I get it. So that's literally how you train your kids to like say certain words or do certain things. So another example is right now, I don't know why he's in this phase where he says okay to everything, and it really bothers me because like, I don't know why he's saying that. So a lot of the time I'll ask him like, Noah, do you wanna go to the park? And he'll just say, okay. And I like, obviously I want like a yes or no answer. So I obviously know he wants to go. So I'll just prompt him to say yes. So I'll say, Noah, do you wanna go to the park? Yes. And he'll say yes. And then I'll ask him again, like, Noah, do you wanna go to the park? And he'll like, I'll prompt him again until he's able to say it independently. So the moment he says, yes, mommy, I'm like, all right, let's go. Like, we're in the car, we're going to the park. So he's immediately getting his fun thing, the park. And he's learning like, okay, my response is yes, not okay. Okay, one more example, because I've been like trying to teach him this, like currently teaching him this, is his age. So this also works not only for like yes or no or like thank you, but it literally works for anything that you want your child to say, to answer a question, or in any scenario, like you can come up with how to teach them and prompt them to say what you want them to say. So I've been trying to have him learn how to say how old he is. So I'll ask him like, how old are you? And then immediately I'll just go like this. So he says two, and I'm like, oh, good job. And then like, I'll ask him again, like, how old are you? And then I'll like literally prompt him every time until he realizes I want you to say two, because that's the right answer. So he has done it one time where he said two independently, and I just like screamed and yelled, and I'm like, oh my God, good job. And he gets so, so excited. Some kids may not like that, so you have to just kind of know your kid and know what they really, really like. So I just threw him a little party and he got really excited. He still doesn't have it down 100%, but that's literally like the basics. Like, that's how you teach with like that ABA style. They just get something fun after, so they know like, oh, I'm doing something right. There's no like punishment to it. If he says the wrong answer, I just backtrack and prompt him either faster or more in his face. So if I go like this and that's not enough, then I'll say like two, so then he knows to say it. So I hope that makes sense. But if I ever do this and I'm able to record it, maybe I can put it in here.
How old are you?
Thank you.
Good job. How old are you?
Two.
Good job. How old are you?
Two.
Good job. Good job, Bubba. You are two. How old are you?
Two.
Good job.
But it happens really naturally, and once you get used to it, you can just do it on a day-to-day, like every situation basis. And then after a while, like your kid just learns like, okay, this is when I say thank you. This is when I say please. This is when I say my name. This is when I say two. Like, it's really, really cool actually. So that's like my top tip. My third tip is to talk to your child about what they like. So this is really important, and I wanted to kind of give this disclaimer in the beginning, but I'll go ahead and say it now. Every kid is different. Every kid learns differently. Every kid learns at a different pace. Like, your kid just may not be ready to talk a whole lot, and that's okay. Like, it's, you don't have to force it. I know it can be stressful. For a little while, I was stressed that Noah wasn't like saying too much, but honestly, when they want to talk, they will talk. And as long as they can communicate and you are able to like know that they are like fed and happy and okay, it's, you know, it's not a big deal that they're not communicating the way you want them to or as quickly as you want them to. Noah is, so he's two now, and he can communicate really well. He has always really loved just like words and letters, and he loves how excited we get when he does talk, and he loves like learning new things. So that's just his personality, and some kids may not, like they might not care to learn new words. But this part I think is like what's important in that, is just learning what your kid likes and teaching them that, because just that will expand their vocabulary and then maybe they'll get interested in other words. So for Noah, it's cars. Like, that is his favorite thing ever. Transportation is really fun for him. So I just had to like get a bunch of cars and toys that he could kind of like learn, like puzzles and stuff. And he has now learned the difference between a car, a school bus, a trash car. He calls it trashy car, which I think is hilarious, but trash car, helicopter, airplane, he literally knows all these different forms of transportation, and it's just because that's what he likes. So if your kid loves dinosaurs, baby, learn all the types of dinosaurs and then teach your kid, because if they're excited about it, they're gonna soak it up and just be so happy. And as they grow, they'll find different things that they really like and they'll expand their vocabulary in that category, if that makes sense. So after transportation and cars, like, he started really getting into animals. So now he knows literally all the animals and all the sounds they make. And it's like incredible that he picked up on everything so fast, but it's just because he's like obsessed with animals. So that's like really important. Find what your kid likes and just talk to them about it. Like, if you have to do research and learn things yourself, do that. I feel like it's, I don't know, it's like an amazing way to just connect with your kids and like really learn what they like and what makes them excited, and they will surprise you with how much they learn. Like, we have these like statues outside of these animals, and Noah learned like an owl does hoot, and then he saw an eagle and he thought, okay, the eagle does hoot too. And we were like, no, like, they do more of like a caw caw. So it took him like maybe a day to learn that, and he immediately was like, okay, eagle does caw. Like, why is that what you're like learning and like being able to retain so well? I don't know, but I'm glad you are. Like, sometimes I'm like, this seems like useless information, but honestly, he is a sponge. He's gonna take every single thing in, especially the things he's excited about. So I love how excited he is about animals. He has a ton of animal books and like toys and stuff. And he honestly, this isn't a tip that I wrote down, but I do think like I want to add this in, is that I'm trying to think of a way to word it, but basically don't underestimate your kids. So we have it's like those 101 books of like words, and we have the animal one, and he loves going through it and looking at all the animals. And there's a page where it's like underwater creatures, and he's learned mostly all of them because I'll go ahead and point and say it, so he'll repeat it, and now he literally knows because he's just obsessed. And I always shied away from like, okay, you know octopus, but like a squid is so similar, so I always just kind of was like, we don't have to say squid, like, I don't want to overwhelm you with all these words. But literally, like, no, like, don't do that. Give them all the words, give them all the information. It's not overwhelming them because they are literally sponges and they will learn it all. So the other day I was finally like, okay, here's the octopus and here's the squid, and he's like, okay, cool, like, squid. Now he knows squid. And it's like, why did I even shy away from telling him that? Like, always don't underestimate your kids. That doesn't make sense, but like, just always give them all the information in the world, even if you think that it's too much for them or it's overwhelming or they're not going to be able to learn all these things at once. Trust me, they freaking will. Like, we taught Noah how to count to 10, and immediately he was like ready to count to 20. Like, he was just like, let's keep going. And in my head, I'm like, oh my God, isn't that like a little too fast? But no, like, don't shy away from teaching your kids literally everything, even if you think it's a little too much. So moving on, my fourth like tip is, obviously you hear like, you should read to your kids. You should, reading's great. But reading to your kids, it's not as important as reading like interactively, which basically means just like I don't know how to put this, but basically what I do is I don't necessarily open a book and read every single word on it. I literally open the book and it becomes like a fun world. Like, we're pointing at things, we're learning the words to things. So for an example, we've been reading The Very Hungry Caterpillar. He's like really into that book right now. And I don't ever really sit there and just read it to him because that can just be like a waste. I feel like it's more important for me to be like, look, it's a little egg and he's laying on the leaf. And look at that. What's that? It's a moon. Wow. The moon and the egg and the leaf. And then I flip the page and I'm like, oh, look, now it's a caterpillar. The caterpillar came out of the egg. Now the caterpillar is super hungry. And then like we flip the page and we look through everything the caterpillar ate. And literally we've read it to the point where Noah like doesn't read it, but he reads it. Like, he knows what's going on. He knows all the fruits, how many. He knows all the foods that the caterpillar ate. Like, and not because I'm reading it, but because I'm like pointing and like having fun with it. So should you read to your kids every day? Yeah, but also make it super fun and teach them words in the book, because also like being able to match pictures to words is obviously like what 100% what you want to do. Like, this is really amazing with like flashcards. We have flashcards for him. He learned them like that. I kid you not. There were words on there that I was like, he's probably not even gonna know them. Literally, the first time I went through the flashcards, I was like, I'm not gonna prompt him. I'm not gonna like do anything. I want to see how much he knew. He knew more than I even thought he did. Like, it was like Q for queen and he got it. And I'm like, what? Like, you literally know all of this. And like, if he hadn't, like, I would have been too scared to teach him every single thing up front. But like, you should, like, pictures and flashcards and teaching everything, like, it's so important. And that's why, like, with books, reading interactively and having just a bunch of pictures of a bunch of different things can really help your kids like learn these words. But I will say, Noah just really loves books. Some kids may not. He just really liked them. He really liked to point out words and say them because he really loves like mine and his dad's reaction to him saying like a new word. We get super excited, like high fives, hugs. Like, we tell him how proud we are and he loves that reaction. So he really, really likes to like say these words. So that's another like mini tip, is like your reactions and your reinforcements really, really, really matter. But moving on to my last point, this one is also really, really important, is to describe everything, literally everything. And I remember like I read this one time when he was like a few months old, and I read like, you should, if you go to the grocery store with your baby, like, talk about everything you see. And I'm like, okay, he's like 2 months, like, I'm not gonna do that. But as he grew older, I did, and I still do every single day, and it's amazing how much they pick up on literally everything you say, how you say it. I don't know how in the world. Like, I posted his 2 year like birthday vlog, and I've never heard him say oh my goodness before. But then like all of a sudden he gets a gift and he's like running around and he's like, oh my goodness, oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness,
up here, okay. You must have just heard one of us say that and now it's like in your vocabulary, which is so freaking funny. So literally, like, just, I mean, that has nothing to do with describing things, but it just shows that anything you say, your kids are listening and picking up on. So when we go out for like walks, I will describe everything. We have literally stopped and helped caterpillars cross the sidewalk, and I'm just like talking about all these different bugs in the sky and the birds. And you know, he hears a hammers because of the construction. We talk about the construction. We literally, like, sometimes we'll walk to see the animals, but then sometimes I'm like, okay, we're gonna walk to go get mommy coffee, like at Starbucks. And he literally immediately picked up on that and like will randomly be like, mommy's coffee? And I'm like, you just want to go outside for a walk, but you literally know that, like, we walk outside to go get coffee. And it's just so funny how your kids will literally pick up on everything as long as you're talking to them constantly and, like, describing everything. It can seem tedious, and I know when you're, like, a working parent and you're really busy, it's hard to, like, sit down and really take the time to talk to your kid in depth and describe everything. Like, it can be annoying, it can, but it's so important, especially if you're looking to help your kid develop their communication skills. It's so amazing to be able to, like, walk around and just point things out. Like, they have construction going on right now, there's tractors out there, he's always looking at, like, the trash car, the trash truck coming. He's constantly looking at things, and I'm constantly telling him, like, what they are. We're always talking about colors of all the cars, and it's just really amazing because he has picked up on everything because me and his dad, we've made it such a point to just describe every little thing. Like, when I'm cooking, I've had him, like, cooking with me, and I'm like, okay, this is butter, and now we're gonna do eggs, and now we're gonna do salt, and now we're gonna mix it up. And it's like, that's just how they learn. And it really takes you putting in the effort to overly describe things. And, like, the same thing with the books, like, you're just describing things to them and they're picking up on it and learning it, and then it just becomes their, like, way of communicating and their vocabulary. And it's so impressive. I honestly haven't kept track of all the words Noah knows, but I might try to, just to kind of give you guys an idea of how many words this little boy knows, because it's just incredible, like, the way that he's able to communicate and just how his vocabulary has expanded over, like, the past year. It's so, so amazing. So I really hope these tips help you guys. If they do, please let me know. Like, I feel like this is, like, my natural element, is talking about, like, kid things. I love talking about just, like, Noah and all the things he does and has accomplished and things for him. And I just feel like this is what I started my channel for. So I really hope that this could help anybody, somebody. And if you guys like this video, please don't forget to actually like the video, comment, share it. Please don't forget to subscribe, click the notification bell, all that good stuff. And I will see you guys in our next video.